Hey friend, this is Anil. So today in this video we will learn how we can integrate Stripe payment gateway in Xamarin. So Stripe is now available in India also. So here I have already implemented for demo purpose. So if you will just click on Stripe Pay, okay, then here you can see the image in process and the payment has been success. So if I let's move on the dashboard. So here you can see I have only one payment, and while I'll refresh it, you can see the another one, just 928. Okay, so how I have implemented this, I will let you know step by step. So here what we have to do first, open just stripe.com. And here you will get the option for start now button, and if we have already created an account, then you can log in also. So just click on Stripe now, and here you will get a create your Stripe account, and from here email ID, full name, password, and confirm password. Just click on create account, and below is sign in button. So actually sign in button is a little bit hide. So here you can see the sign in button. Okay, so if you have already account, you can sign in over here. So I have signed in over here already. So here you can see my payment history. So how we will achieve this, let's move on to the studio. So if you didn't subscribe my channel, then please subscribe my channel. Just click on the Studio 2019, and here I will click on create a new project. So we are going to implement it from fresh, and here we have a mobile app Xamarin. So I'll just choose a template, just click on create button. So here I will pick a name like Stripe payment. Okay, now just click on create button. So here I will create a blank application. I have Android and iOS only. Just click on OK button. So here my application is ready. I'll just go on mainpage.xml. And if you want to create another page also, you can create. So here what we have to do, we have to install one plugin, that is stripe.com. So I'll go in the tool, and from here I will download a plugin, Stripe. Okay, so make sure you are installing the correct one. This is the correct one. Okay, just click on install button, click on accept. Yes, your plugin has been installed. Now let's move here, and here I will just create a button. But here if you want, you can take the input from the credit card, like credit card number, CVV number, and expiry date also. So I will let you know how we'll do that. Pay, Stripe Pay, Stripe Pay. Okay, click here. I will fire a new event handler. Cool. Now let's go in backend. So backend, we will create a method. So that method is basically for payment, public bool. Cool. make payment. Okay, and here we have to pass a token. How we will generate that token? I will let you know. Okay, so here I'll use try and catch. Exception ex. Okay, so now let's move on another one, that is for token. So here I will create a token. Public string create token. Try and catch. Okay, so here what I will do, I will create I will set a stripe test API key. So stripe configuration. So just add using stripe, okay, and dot set API key. Okay, so here I have to pass the API key. So let's create a variable for the API key over here. So for token also I will use public token and stripe token. Okay, and the another one is public token and token service. I will let you know what is the use of these variable and public token service. Okay, the last one is public string and test API key. From where we will get the test API key? So I already told you that once you will register and login over here, then here in developer option, this is my dashboard. So you will get the same dashboard over here, and this is the API key. Okay, so this API key you have to just copy and paste over here. Okay, now again let's move on our method set API key, and in the API key I'll pass the API key string stripe. What was the name actually? Test API key. Cool. So here we will define a service equals to new charge service. Okay. And where token option equals to new token create option. So here we are going to create a token option. Okay, so now card, and in the card equals to new credit card. So here you can see we are getting different option. Okay, credit note line option, different option. So we are using the credit card options, and here I will use my credit card information. So suppose if you want the information from your front end screen or from this screen, then you have to just create a text box for credit card and credit card number, expiry date, and for CVV number. But I'm putting everything as a hard code. Okay, so here I will take number equals to number and expiry year. Okay, suppose let's put 22. I will let you know why I'm putting 22. Expiry month equals to 12. Okay, CVV equals to 889. We'll let you know why I'm putting 889 or 12 and 22. Okay, and the name equals to, suppose I'm putting Anil Tips Y Demo. Okay, and the next is address. Okay, so address line 1 equals to, suppose I'm putting XYZ, and address line 2 equals to, suppose I'm putting LMN. So whatever address of the customer you can provide over here. Okay, and even it's not required also, then address city equals to Pune and address street equals to, suppose, Maharashtra. Okay, and address country equals to India, and here is the last address, zip equals to INR. So I have put this. Okay, now let's do this. And now what I will do, so here token service equals to new token service, token service. I will create a object stripe token. We have created the variable for stripe token equals to token service dot create. So what it will do, token option, that token option I will put over here. So it will create a token and it will return us stripe token. Okay, so this token we need. Token dot id. Okay, now this is in try and this is in catch. What I did, this complete thing I will copy and paste over here in try. Cool. Now let's move on another method, that is make payment. Okay, so here I'm just copying and paste the code. Okay, and will make you understand because the video is going very long. So here what I have did is Stripe configuration dot set API. So in this we are putting our API key. So from where I will get the API key, here just click on this button and you will get the API key. Okay, so this is our test API key. Okay, the same API key I put it already over here. Okay, so our code is ready. So what we have did in the code, first here you can see we have created a method for payment async, and in the payment async here once user will click on the payment button, then a token will be created. And what is this token? this token will authenticate our web API. Sorry, not web API, actually authenticate our API key. And if the API key is correct and the information is parameter, all the parameter is correct, then it will return the token. Okay, so from where I have taken this information, this information I have taken from here. So here is, you can see the URL is step.com/docs/testing. So the number you can see, and CVV is any 3-digit CVV and any future date. Okay, so the same I have put it over here, and once the token will be generated, then it will check in the payment async method, it will check if the token is available, means token is not equals to null, it will go for make payment method. And what is the make payment method? So that method you can see over here, Stripe configuration dot set API key. So this API key I already told you from where we are getting this API key. So I'll let you know it again, this API key we are getting from here. Okay, secret key. So we are using two keys, first for publishing key, this is for token, and secret key, this is for payment. Okay, here keep remember this key for token and this key for make payment. So here I have put it this amount, and here some parameter I have put it. And now let's run this application again. So here we can see the button is very small. We have to remove this horizontal option equals to center so that it will be a little bit longer. Okay, now just click on this button and we will get, again we will get a error. Here you can see the error is acr dot user dialogs in Android, you must call user dialog dot init. So here we have to in Android go in main activity, and here we have to define a user dialog. So we will initialize here user dialogs dot init and run this application again. Just click on Stripe Pay. So here you can see processing payment and it's success. Just click on OK button. And let's move on dashboard. So here we have to go in payment option. So in the payment option you can see just this payment 1330 and date is 14 July 2216. Okay, now if you want test it again, then again hit this button and payment processing, it's done. Let's move on again over here and refresh this screen. Again you can see the same amount. So I hope you like this video, and if you like this video then please subscribe my channel. And the code is over here, you can see. I'll just zoom it out. I don't have, my server has been expired actually, so I'm not able to put the code on my domain. So here you can see the code. So here first I have created a payment async method. You can just check the code and you can take the hints from here. Okay, and this is the make payment method and this is the create token. Thanks for watching my video. Have a nice day. Bye bye.